إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد الحمد لله we should all be smiling right now because in 2 weeks we will enter the month of Ramadan inshallah so we make the dua Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, let us reach the month of Ramadan. And why are we so desperate to make this dua? Because we know the virtue of Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions and their students, the Salaf, the righteous predecessors, they would make dua 6 months prior to Ramadan, asking Allah azza wa jal, Oh Allah, let us reach Ramadan. Because they knew the virtue of Ramadan. They knew the importance of this month. It is said, one of the dua they used to make, the Salaf, they would say, Allahumma salimni ila Ramadan. Oh Allah, keep me safe until Ramadan. Keep me healthy. Keep me alive until the month of Ramadan. Wa salim li Ramadan. And keep Ramadan safe for me. Wa tasalamhu minni mutakabbalan. And they would say, accept Ramadan for me. Allahu Akbar. We know this month Ramadan is the month of the Quran. It is the month of fasting. It is the month of forgiveness. It is the month of mercy. It is the month of ibadah. It is the month where you do good deeds. Allah reward you multiple times, from 10 to 700 times. This month is blessed. This month, we should be happy that it is coming. And may Allah Azza wa Jal protect you and I and keep us safe until the month of Ramadan. Allah Azza wa Jal says about this month. Allah says, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. That the month of Ramadan is the month that the Quran was sent down. It is the month that we receive the guidance. هُدَى لِلنَّاسِ That's the Quran. It is the guidance for mankind. وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ It is the guidance that makes everything clear for us. It guides us to what is right to, and it keeps us away to what is wrong. The Quran, it guides us. It shows us who are the people of Jannah. It shows us who are the people of hellfire. The Quran makes everything clear. Well, the Furqan is a criterion. It distinguishes between bad and good. That's the Quran. That's what makes Ramadan blessed. Every scripture, it is said in Kathir, he said every scripture that Allah Azza wa Jal sent down, the Torah, the Injil, the Zabur, all of these scriptures, they were sent down in the month of Ramadan. This month is blessed. Allah Azza wa Jal, He's the creator and He chose Ramadan above all the months. Allah tells us, when you and I, when we see ourselves in the month of Ramadan, what are we supposed to do? When Ramadan comes, Allah said, فَمَنْ أَشْهِدَ مِنْكُمْ أَشْهَرَ فَلْيَسُمْ Allah says, whoever among you see themselves in the month of Ramadan, you witness the month of Ramadan, what do you do? فَلْيَسُمْ Fast in it. Allahu Akbar. That's why we fast, because this verse makes it obligatory on all of us to fast. But Allah says, وَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخرى. Allah said, but whoever is sick, you get up in the night, or you get up, you're not feeling well. Allah give you an excuse. Allah said, you don't have to fast, but you gotta make it up. If you're traveling, Allah also give you an excuse. You have to make it up. You don't have to fast. Then Allah said, يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر. Allah Azza wa Jal, He intends for you and I to have ease. Allah wants ease for us. So Allah said, I'm not trying to burden you. If you are sick, it's okay. You don't have to fast. But you have to make it up later on, after Ramadan. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when Ramadan comes, he will come to his sahaba. He will say, قد جاءكم رمضان شهر مبارك. Ramadan has come to you. This is a blessed month. افترض الله عليكم صيامه. Allah has obligated on you to fast on Ramadan. Then the Prophet, he lists things that happen in Ramadan. When Ramadan comes, what happens? He says, تفتح فيه أبواب الجنة. The gates of Jannah, all the 8 gates, they are open. Allahu Akbar. To show you and I that this month, Ramadan, it is the month where it is easy for you and I to attain Jannah. Allah made the atmosphere. Allah made things so easy for us to gain Jannah. Then he said, وَيُغْلَقُ فِيهِ أَبْوَابُ الْجَحِيمِ. And the gates of hellfire are closed. Allahu Akbar. Then he said, وَتُغَلُّ فِيهِ الشَّيَاطِينِ. The devils, they are chained. Allahu Akbar. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said, what does that mean they are chained? When someone is chained, then you are restricted. You don't have that influence anymore. Your influence is low. Allah Azza wa Jalla wants you and I to have no distraction. All the whispers you get in other months, in Ramadan, it is less. You are more strong. That's why you come on in the masjid at Fajr time. The masjid is packed. People have the strength to get up. People have the strength to fast. People have the strength to do good deeds. People have the strength to come to night prayers. Why? Because that influence you used to have, the devil's influencing you, it is less. Because why? وَتُظَلُّ فِيهِ الشَّيَاطِينِ. Allah Azza wa Jal has chained them. SubhanAllah. Then he says, in Ramadan, فِيهِ لَيْلَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهَرٍ. Allahu Akbar. In Ramadan, there's one night that is better than 1,000 months. It is not equal to. So many times you see people say it's equal to. No. خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهَرٍ. This one night, it is better than 1,000 months. Then the Prophet says, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, مَنْ حُرِمَ خَيْرَهَا. Whoever is deprived of the good in Ramadan, whoever is deprived of it, meaning Ramadan came and you didn't take advantage of it. Ramadan came, instead of changing for the better, you didn't take it seriously, you wasted time, you didn't take advantage of the good in Ramadan. مَنْ حُرِمَ خَيْرَهَا قَدْ حُرِمَ. Whoever is deprived of the good in Ramadan, then you've truly been deprived. Allahu Akbar. Now I want to take a second and talk about fasting. Because when you think about Ramadan, we think about fasting. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلِّ. Allah says, كُلُّ عَمَلِ بْنِ آدَمَ لَهُ إِلَّا الصِّيَامِ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنْ أَجْزِي بِهِ. Allahu Akbar. Allah Azza wa Jal says that every deed the son of Adam does, all your good deed is for you. But Allah picked Ramadan fasting. Allah said, no, fasting is for me. Brothers and sisters, listen. When you fast, do you know no one truly knows if you are fasting or not? No one can verify that you are fasting. I can verify that I saw you pray. I can verify that I saw you give sadaqah. But how can I truly verify that you didn't go around the corner and drink water? Who is stopping you from going to your car, going to around the corner and buy food? Who is stopping you? I'm not following you. No one is following you. SubhanAllah. It's the taqwa in Allah Azza wa Jal. Because you know Allah is watching you. You're doing it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. That's what Allah said. فَإِنَّهُ لِي. Fasting is for me. And وَأَنَّ أَجْزِي بِهِ. Even the angels, they don't know the reward of fasting. Allah keep it between you and him. Allahu Akbar. May Allah make that easy for us. The Prophet said, يَدَعُ شَهْوَةَ. Allah said, يَدَعُ شَهْوَتَهُ وَطَعَامُهُ مِنْ أَجْلِي. Allah said, the son of Adam, meaning the human being, he gives up his desire. He gives up his food for my sake. SubhanAllah. Things that's halal for you. Food. But when you're fasting for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, you give it up. Your desire, husband and wife, when they are fasting, they can stay together. What I mean by that, you guys know what I mean by that. So when they are fasting, they do that for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Then the Prophet said, وَصِيَامُ جُنَّةٌ. Fasting is a shield. When you're fasting, it protects you from haram. It gives you the strength. You're more conscious. It makes your desire weak. You're in control of your temptation. You control your temptation. Because the Prophet says, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to a young man, he said, if you are able to get married, get married. Then he said, if you're not able to get married, then do what? Fast. Because that gives you the strength to control your desire. It lessens the desire. Allahu Akbar. Then the Prophet said, if you are fasting, remember this, brothers and sisters. Let's remember this. And other sisters will be watching online. Remember this, that when you are fasting, the Prophet said, فَإِنْ سَبَّهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ قَاتَلَهُ. If someone insults you when you're fasting or try to fight you, what do you say? فَلْيَقُلْ إِنِّمْرُؤٌ صَائِمٌ. When you're fasting, when someone insults you, they say anything bad about you, it doesn't matter. Even if they try to entice you, they try to make you give up. Guess what? No. Don't lose your reward. Tell them, I am fasting, and walk away. Allahu Akbar. Tell them, I am fasting. Then the Prophet said, مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ. Whoever does not turn away from bad words and bad action. You don't turn away when you fast and you stay involved in cussing. You stay involved in watching bad things. You stay involved in fighting. You stay involved in doing haram. You don't give this up when you're fasting. Look what he said. فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَجَّةٌ فِي أَنْ يَدَعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. Allah Azza wa Jalla is not in need of you to leave your food and your drink. Because you're going to waste your time. Here you are fasting, but your behavior is still bad. You behave rudely. You cuss. So fasting is not just about staying away from food and water. No. It's also about controlling yourself, your manners, to be conscious of your action. This is why we are talking Ramadan. When Ramadan comes, brothers and sisters, remember, never let anyone entice you to act bad. Don't gossip. Leave it up. Don't fight anyone. Leave it up. This because you want to attain the reward of your fasting. You want Allah to accept it from you. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, when Ramadan comes, وَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ, the caller calls. There's an angel. He makes a special announcement. This happens every night in Ramadan. وَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ, يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ أَقْبِلْ. Oh, seeker of good. All those that were already doing good before Ramadan came. Oh, you Muslim that were already involved in praying night prayer. You were fasting before. You were doing good. This is Ramadan. أَقْبِلْ. Advance. Proceed. Go come near, meaning go extra mile. You were doing good before, but guess what? Add more to it. So Ramadan come, those that were involved in doing good already, they should increase in their good. If you are reading Quran 1 hour a day, guess what? Make it 3 hours in Ramadan. If you are reading Quran 5 hours a day, make it 6 hours. Increase, subhanAllah. Then he says, وَيَبَاغِ الشَّرِّ. All those who are involved in bad, those who are doing haram before Ramadan started. Before Ramadan, you didn't pray. Before Ramadan, you didn't care. You went out with no cover. You were saying bad words. You gossip. But Ramadan is here now. What do you do? Aqsir. Relax. Stop. This is the month of Ramadan. Give up your bad habit. Give them up. This is a special month. This is the month where you want Allah Azza wa Jalla to change you for the better. You want Allah Azza wa Jalla. You want your taqwa to go up. Because we know Allah said that fasting has been prescribed upon you. Why? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So perhaps you may attain taqwa. So when Ramadan comes, give up your bad habit. It's only for 30 days. SubhanAllah. If you can sacrifice for that, say this month, I'm going to change myself. And inshallah, you continue with that after Ramadan. Because that's the goal. That you, 30 days you practice, and then after that you continue. Then he said, وَلِلَّهِ أُتَّقَعُ مِنَ النَّارِ. Allah saves people in Ramadan every night from hellfire. وَذَلِكَ كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ. And that's every night in Ramadan, people are getting saved from hellfire. SubhanAllah. May Allah make you and I from those that are saved from hellfire. Ameen. SubhanAllah. What a month. That's why we say, Allahumma baligna Ramadan. Oh Allah, make us reach the month of Ramadan. Because it is a virtue, it is a blessed month. And we want to experience it. We want to live through it. We want to be healthy and experience and fast the whole month. This is the month of forgiveness. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ صَوْمَ رَمَضَانَ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. SubhanAllah. He said, whoever fast in the month of Ramadan, إِيمَانًا, with belief, with sincerity, وَاحْتِسَابًا, seeking Allah's reward. You fast and you expect Allah to reward you. You seek, you think good of Allah, that I'm not doing this for fun. Allah Azza wa Jal will accept it for me. Allah Azza wa Jal will reward it. You know what's going to happen? What's your reward if you fast sincere in Ramadan? What's your reward? Allah will forgive all your past sins. Man soma Ramadan. It's not done yet. Another one comes. He said, Man qama Ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaban. All the way to the end. Whoever stands in prayer in Ramadan, you can't do Taraweeh prayer, or you do it at home, it doesn't matter. But you pray at night, subhanAllah. What's going to happen? غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. Again, Allah will forgive all your past sins. It's not done yet. We can keep going. He said, مَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ. Subhanallah. Whoever stands in the night of prayer, the night of power, لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ, you pray. What's going to happen? Again, إِمَانًا, with belief. وَاحْتِسَابًا, sincerity. You expect Allah's reward. You seek the reward of Allah Azza wa Jal. غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. And we are all sinners. We want Allah to forgive our sin. This Ramadan, we hope that we leave Ramadan as a newborn baby. Brothers, this month is 30 days in it. 30 days for you and I to take advantage. For you and I to be the best version of ourselves. To be the best Muslim in this month. Subhanallah. If this month comes and you don't take advantage of it, guess what? Guess who made dua against you? Jibril made dua against someone that Ramadan comes and he don't take advantage of it. One day the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was climbing the pulpit. Every time he climbed, he said, Ameen. He did it 3 times. I'm going to focus on just one for the sake of time. He said 3 times, Ameen. After he was done, the Sahaba, the companions, they asked him, we saw you do something we never saw you do before. Why did you say Ameen? Look what the Prophet said. Inna Jibreel atani. Jibreel, the angel Gabriel, the best of angels, he came to me at that moment. He said, فَقَالَ مَنْ أَدْرَكَ شَهْرَ رَمَضَانِ. Whoever reached the month of Ramadan, you are healthy, you are alive, Ramadan comes. وَلَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ فَدَخَلَ النَّارِ. Subhanallah. He said, if Ramadan comes, the person is alive, he's healthy, and he doesn't get his sins forgiven, then may he enter hellfire. Jibreel said, قُلْ آمِين. فَقُلْتُ آمِين. Subhanallah. He told the Prophet ﷺ, say Ameen to this dua. So the Prophet said, so I said Ameen. Jibreel, the best of angels, he made the dua about the person that comes in Ramadan. He didn't take advantage of it. He didn't stop. But opposite, he continued doing his bad habits. Instead of sacrificing this 30 days to do good, to increase in good. No, he didn't care. He took Ramadan as if it's any other month. He didn't change his life. Guess what? He didn't get forgiven. Because Ramadan, the stage, Allah designed this month for to make it easy for us for our sins to be forgiven. So if that month come and you are alive, you're healthy, you don't take advantage of it. So Jibreel and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they make dua that may that person enter hellfire, because how easy can it get for you? Allahu Akbar. So brothers and sisters, may Allah Azza wa Jal, may you and I, those that take advantage of this month that's coming, may Allah Azza wa Jal make us reach Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala deenik. Rabbana afriq alina sabaran wa tawaffana muslimin. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursalin. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wa aqimus salat.